Generative art is described as any artistic practice where the artist uses a system such as a set of natural language rules with some degree of autonomy. The artwork is generated, at least in part, by some process that is not under the artist's direct control. Additionally, the term generative art is sometimes referred to as algorithmic art, computational art, and many others, even though some experts believe that some of these labels have distinct differences. What makes generative art stands out from any other art is that, first, the initial rules are crucial and must be constructive. These rules can be implemented through lines of code, which is why coding is a vital aspect of generative art. Although, not all generative art involves computers. Pre-computer examples use basic geometrical figures or calculable instructions. Secondly, the system automatically generates the artwork, so the artist or the creator would have no direct control over the final result. However, they can still modify the system to be either fully or partially automated. Lastly, the outcome can be presented in various art forms such as pictures, music, architecture, and even performance art. The system can also potentially produce multiple outcomes, so it is possible that some results may not fulfill the observer's expectations. Furthermore, the development of generative art started in the 1960s when digital computer graphics became accessible. At the time, several mathematicians and engineers were researching computer-generated art. Some pioneers opened the first exhibition of computer-generated art, and some created an invention to purposely generate art. A few years later, individuals with an artistic background explored digital computer graphics and used them in their art practice as well. The method they were commonly used is called plotter. A plotter is a system that executes the algorithm to plot the generated art by automatically moving the mounted pen in a way that the system is drawing by itself. Even though the first exhibition of generative art did not go well, generative art still had an impact from the earliest day. For example, a painting created by a famous artist who used conventional methods was inspired by a computer-generated artist. Fast forward to the last decade, generative art has become more applicable than ever. In recent years, people have taken advantage of current technology to make their computer-generated artwork more dynamic. For instance, generative art has been used to make modern art exhibitions interactive by combining electrical and mechanical systems, further enhancing the experience for the viewers. Moreover, the same techniques used in generative art have been applied to compose songs, develop video games, construct buildings, organize swarm robot systems, and many more. AI-generated art is also a thing now, where the system is trained so it can learn and generate an original work of art. Besides those applications, It is also possible to sell generative art not only as a piece of physical artwork, but also as a digital art piece. So how can someone make generative art? Processing IDE and p5.js are two of the most popular tools for creating generative visual art. Both platforms are free and have extensive documentation. Besides these two, there are other alternative platforms that focus more on 3D construction, multimedia creation, and even generative art creation without coding. Once you've chosen the right tool, many YouTube tutorials are available for free to help you get started. I also recommend reading these two books, which explain the techniques commonly used in generative art, such as flow field and cellular automata. Last but not least, there is a website called Open Processing where people can share and discover computer-generated artworks complete with the code.